Joseph Patrick Hart was born August 30, 1918, in Saginaw. After graduating from St. Andrews High School, he attended the University of Notre Dame, where he graduated in 1940. While at Notre Dame, he was the football manager and worked with two of the most famous coaches, Elmer Leyden of Four Horsemen fame and Frank Leahy.
He loved his job, but I think he loved Notre Dame a lot better.
Yeah, Leahy and Leighton, they both sent him a Western Union telegram when he graduated. I still have those.
Hart then served in the U.S. Army during World War II. He started his full-time newspaper career in 1944 at the Middletown Times-Herald in New York. He then moved back to Saginaw to help his ill father manage the family business, the Fred C. Hart Coal Company. At the same time, he wrote for the Catholic Weekly and worked part-time for the Saginaw News. Hart joined the Saginaw News as a full-time sports reporter in 1950 and was named sports editor in 1959. Hart was appointed executive sports editor in 1969 and retired in August of 1973.
Yeah, we covered 60 high schools all the way up to Alpena to the north, out to the Thumb, and south to Birch Run, so it was a sizable area.
He covered everything out there and that did a great job for us of publicizing baseball.
I found him to be a guy who truly loved sport.
His nickname was Injun Joe because he had written several stories in Indian dialect.
I think it was because when he was out in the sun, he got red.
Injun Joe was one. He used to write a column and it was called Injun Joe Hart. He didn't do this all the time, but just occasionally.
The first story was about a high school athletic contest involving Pontiac Central. He had his own style, which flowed rhythmically, and his leads to stories always captured the high point and the key to the event.
And I thought he was an exceptional writer who had a unique style of writing. When he covered a sports event and wrote the article for the sports event, he made it seem like you were there right now watching it.
It was just amazing on the articles that he wrote and that coverage, you know, pictures and the lineups and the, you know, looked like just like they do for the professional baseball games now.
He had a way of writing that kept people's interest. I mean, he had that human interest quality to his writing that, during Christmas he'd put in something about Santa Claus, and St. Patrick's Day would be something about leprechauns, and it was a unique writing style.
Yeah, he did it wasn't like your normal article, because he would throw a lot of things like that in his articles that would would distinguish him in some ways, and he liked to do it that way, and I think other people appreciated that too, and he had a lot of people that liked what he did, so.
What most people don't realize is that he'd write columns and have to work with the deadlines and then physically set up the headlines and articles. He later would head back to work with the printers, who would have to set up the line sets for the big printing machines.
And back then they used to work with the printers too. It wasn't like it is now where you just turn in something. They had to actually go and physically work with the printers and everything too.
One of his local loves was the Saginaw District Golf Association Tournament, one of the most prestigious golf events in Saginaw. It was Hart's vision behind its inception in 1955, and he was actively involved in the association through the 22nd annual event. He served as the official starter of the district tournament, announcing the names and club affiliations of each golfer.
Well, he had his passions, and one of them was golf. And he was instrumental in starting the Saginaw District Golf Association.
He was actually on the first original tournament committee, board of directors, and he was really responsible for the Saginaw News sponsoring the event. You know, fittingly, they've named the tournament trophy after in his honor.
Bringing that to Saginaw and getting that kind of tournament in Saginaw, he spent a lot of time at it and enjoyed doing it.
I came home one weekend and he was just getting backing out of the driveway, and I said, "Where are you going?" He's going, "I'm gonna go announce the starters at the over at the golf, and come on, get in the car, and I'll take you with me." And I went over there, and that was just right before he died.
Hart was active in the Notre Dame Alumni Association, the Knights of Columbus Council number 593, and was past president of the Michigan Sports Editors Association. The veteran newspaper man helped shape the careers of Saginaw News sports writers Jim Buckley, John Posnell, Jim McGovern, Joe Walker, Dwayne Lancaster, and Dick Wood. He passed away June 16, 1976, at the age of 57, and is buried at Mount Olive Cemetery.